Hello, Serge here from the back porch. We have a question here from Campy M, and this is one that has involved some physical issues. So I think this is very appropriate since we're the body friendly site, and see if we can't give Campy a little help here. He says, I have bursitis in my left hip. I'm left handed. Any tips on decreasing impact on my hip? It is starting to hurt after 18 holes. I'm 63 years old. Don't plan on stopping golf. A short golf thought to decrease hip pressure, please. Okay, I think we can possibly help you out here, Campy. And the key is that you're being left-handed. Your left hip will be your back hip or your trailing hip in the swing. All right. So if you don't mind, I'm going to do this right-handed because I can make all my movements and gestures so much better. So I'll be talking about my right hip, but it still applies to all lefties in there and their left hip. So I'll talk about back hip or trailing hip today. I think the number one thing to set to really consider here is setup. And what is the number one basic thing about setup as far as the feet and the knees go in the surge swing? That is, we want the feet flared about 30 degrees and wide knees. And so the key is, I think that you might want to start experimenting with maybe flaring your front foot a little bit more. Because again, if your foot isn't flared enough, once you transfer your weight to your forward leg, that leg, and if the knee can't rotate enough, the kneecap can't rotate enough, and the foot roll over, that's like hitting a wall, and as that wall, you know, locks up here, especially the forward hip locks up, what's happening now? Your back hip, your trailing hip, would be hindered in moving anymore, so it gets a pretty darn good jolt right in the hip, and it gets even more worse as you try to follow through, and your arms reach out there, you get a jerk all the way down the back of the right side of the back, in my case, the trailing back side, which is my right side, down to the right hip. So if we get the foot open and flared more, you might try to flare it a little bit more and more and see that you get a smoother transition to the forward side. But here's the key we have to remember. When you have your toes on the aiming line, if you flare your front foot more, you just can't flare it and like this, because now you'd be open and you'd be swinging sideways to your target, not at your target. So if you open that forward foot more, you have to make sure that you lift it and keep the toe on the aiming line so that your knees when you make your shift are still going to cover, as I say, cover your toes, which allows your knees and your back and your back trailing arm and side to be able to swing down and through at the target into that forward mitt and up the tree. So that's the critical point about if you flare your feet more. And I mean, people say, well, how can you flare more? I can actually stand here and point my foot at the target and still hit good shots and stand straight up at the target, and it completely releases it. The feeling I want to talk about is, as far as your impact position goes and through impact, is that with the surge swing and the shallow divots where we're just nipping the ball off the ground and standing up, is I actually feel that when I swing properly with the amount of my left foot, my forward foot flared open, and I'm always usually at least 45 degrees or more than the normal, what we suggest is 30. Because again, my feet have a tendency to really flare out extra more far flared than most people, and that's because it's just a situation of my anatomy. Never broken any bones or whatever, but my feet just point out a lot more, and so I need that extra degree of the feet being flared, especially the forward foot, to be able to smoothly swing through impact. And by smoothly, I mean I feel like when I hit a golf ball and things are right and my knees are staying flexed and my forward foot is rolling over, that I feel when I hit the ball and go through it, I feel this like little snap. I actually call it, when my arms straighten out to impact and my head goes back a little bit and pops up, it looks like a karma. I call it the dipsy doodle. And so I feel like not only does my golf club, when it hits the ball, skip off the ground, I feel like my whole right side, from the knee to the hip to the shoulder, I feel that when all of that, once I hit the ball, all of that just kind of, that also just skips and ricochets up to the finish as I'm swinging up. And that's a feeling that I think that really helps me to make sure that I'm able to really accelerate to impact, through, and up to the tee finish. So as I said, just like my club ricochets off the ground, I want my whole right side also in the swing to feel like, boom, it ricochets and pops up. And I really think that for anybody with any hip issues or knee issues, really consider opening up, flaring more your forward foot. And I think that'll really help. And then add this, that you want your body to to also skip up like you want the club to be nipping the ball and ricocheting up to the finish. So ricochet the club off the ground and ricochet and snap your body up with that Dipsy Doodle Pop-Tart stand up tee finish. And I think you'll find that you should start relieving that pressure on your trailing hip. All right, well, that's it for the surge for today, and I'll be talking to y'all again soon.